My parents got divorced when I was 8.
Did you see any of the fights? Did you feel the animosity? Or was it just like one day you're like, hey, fun new project. Mommy and daddy are getting separate houses.
No, it was ugly at the end. Like there were like cops called. And,
oh my God.
And stuff like that. Yeah, no, it got bad toward the end. And there's a lot of stuff that in hindsight is a lot more horrifying than it was when I was 8 and my brother was 5.
And that's not what we're going to talk about?
No, we're going to talk about, because that's not really funny.
Right, right. This has become the therapy album for Justin Robert Young.
We are going to talk about my father post-divorce.
Right.
My father post-divorce was, much as he was during marriage, an alcoholic. And, you know, wrestled with that here and again. He's living in St. Thomas.
Mm-hmm.
And because he is not near where me and where my mom lived in South Florida anymore, we couldn't do every other weekend, so we would just pile up his court allotted time with me and my brother, and we would then spend that time between spring breaks and summers down on
the
beach.
So, like, instead of getting a Saturday every week, you would, you know, pretty much be with mom and then go spend a week with dad in the Virgin Islands.
But it would be like two weeks or 3 weeks sometimes. Yeah. Like, it would be, we'd spend a large period of time. He never really stopped drinking. But every once in a while, he would go through like phases that were dry, and then he would get just surprisingly drunk.
Oh my God.
Like, it would sneak, because, like, he would start out, it'd be dry Monday.
Right.
Tuesday, he'd have 2 beers with dinner, and that'd be it.
Right.
And then, like, Wednesday, it would start out with 2 beers, and then it would just kind of snowball into him just getting drunk and ridiculous.
Oh, my gosh.
We're sitting on the couch, and he's smoking. My little brother has gone to sleep on the couch. If there's one thing that my little brother evolved at a very early age was, Dad's getting drunk. Nothing can happen to me if I'm asleep.
Oh,
so I'm
going
to go to sleep immediately. I was not so lucky. So I'm sitting across now from my dad. My dad is now increasingly more drunk and is smoking inside the house, which he never does.
Right.
And he's like, would you kiss a black girl? And I'm like, yes. I mean, I guess so. Takes a drag of a cigarette.
I would like to point out that you're pantomiming all of this right now.
Would you ever fuck a black girl?
How old are you?
13.
Oh, my God. So this is around the time, like, I'm playing spin the bottle at this point, and your dad is haranguing you about whether or not you'd bone a black chick.
I haven't come close to fucking anybody, right? I'm just figuring out, like, how all that equipment really works.
See, I would love to picture you, like, being sassy, like, I don't know, she got tits? Then yes, I fuck it.
Yes, no, there was none of that. There would just be, I go, I don't know. Takes another drag of a cigarette. You're a racist.
What? Because you said you didn't know?
Because I didn't know if I'd fuck
a Oh my God. And you're 13 and your dad just flat out says it. And at 13, you don't think, like, you don't fight back. You know, you don't think this is a time for a spirited debate. You're just like, I guess it's true.
This is my dad.
Oh.
Like, I'm just looking at him and just like, I'm like, well, I don't know. How does that make me racist if I just haven't, I mean, I haven't known a black girl that I've even close to.
Sure, sure.
Kissing.
Yeah.
You're a racist. And at that point, he just got, like, he almost got resigned. Like, he'd figured something out. Finally, he cracked the code.
He stands up and he knocks over a lamp crying, my son is a racist. I can't believe he hesitated about fucking a black chick.
So then he decides to turn on the Gypsy Kings.
Oh my God, really?
Really love the Gypsy Kings. He turns on the Gypsy Kings really loud. So I decide, I'm like, okay, I'll just go to bed. So I walk around him. He's in front of me, between me and the room I was staying in.
Sure.
I go around him to go to sleep, and I try to sleep thinking, this will eventually burn himself out.
Right, right.
2 hours later,
no,
the Gypsy Kings are still going, and he keeps playing the album over and over and over again.
No.
Yes. So I come. Wait,
wait, wait, is this a scathing indictment of your racism?
And so he's going to
inundate you with the Gypsy
Kings. I don't know what's happening. So I go out and I'm like, I'm like, and I'm like, 13-year-old kid, like, Dad, I'm trying to sleep. And then looks at me and says, I make the rules here.
No.
And I don't even think it was the next day. This is years later. I talked to my brother about that night.
Right.
Because it was so weird.
Well, yeah.
And he's like, I think that was the same night that Dad woke me up. And he's like, Eric. And so my little brother, he's got to be at this point 10 years old.
Sure.
Turns over. You're my favorite.
No. No. No.
Because he'd found the true racist in me.
Oh, my God. What? What does that do to your brother? He's like, I am the chosen one.
I don't know. I mean, he's always like, it was one of those weird things. He had no idea where it came from because he wasn't conscious for any of the stuff that had happened. He just thought it was a sweet thing his dad was saying to him.
Oh, my God. That is awesome, question mark. I guess awesome in the literal sense of the word, and that it is all inspiring. I don't even know where to go with this. I'm like, where's the comedy in here?
I find it funny.